Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you on this fine day? Me? I am spectacular. I thank you very much for inquiring. Today, one of my most requested demos, or one of the things that I've been asked the most. How do I get my iPhone and iPad screen into these videos that I produce? It's quite simple, but it's an awesome little tip. So a quick TubeTorial today on Dotto Tech. I don't know how many times I've been asked this, but probably in double digits, people asking, how do I get my iPhone and iPad screens into these videos? And can we do it with our Android phones? Well, I've got good news and I got bad news. The good news is it's really easy on the Mac to get to record your screens. It's really difficult to record Android and Windows screens, Windows OS or any other mobile OS. At least onto the Mac, and certainly even into Windows, it's not all that easy. But let me walk you through the process on the Mac. Pretty straightforward, actually. It just requires a single piece of software. Now, there's several ways to get to here. This is the one that I use. And, oh my gosh, it's cheaper than it used to be when I bought it. I use an app called Reflector, which allows me to basically mirror my iOS screen and have it display on the Mac. And it uses AirPlay. It uses Apple's media sharing tools. But the cool thing about it is it allows me to also share the OS as opposed to just send a video through. See, there's lots of tools that will allow you to take the video or what you're watching, like if you're watching a YouTube video or something on your device, and send it to a television screen or to a computer screen. But seeing the operating system, that's the key. That's what Reflector does for me. So let me show you how it all comes together. So you have to buy Reflector, $12.99 out of your pocket, into their pocket. You install it. And when you install Reflector, it's pretty simple. I've got it running here, and they've just got a couple of very simple preferences and configuration options for it. But you basically ask it to optimize for whatever screen you're going to be delivering it to. And then, once that's done, you can basically, once it's running, if you launch AirPlay in your device, it should come up. So let's give it a try. I'm going to just take my iPhone right here. Here's my iPhone, nothing fancy. I'm just going up. And I'm tapping on the AirPlay icon, and I'm hitting Steve's iMac, which is my iMac, and there it is. It appears right away. Now, I can scale this. Now, I capture my screens using ScreenFlow, which I've talked about often. But what just happened, if we take a look at, you know, if you want to kind of replay what I just did, was I just swiped up at the bottom of my iOS screen in order to bring up the preferences. And there I tapped on the AirPlay icon, and then I chose the device that I wanted, which is Steve's iMac. So you can set it up for any device. And once that was done, I have sharing going forward. Now what I will do as I'm editing this is I'll zoom in and out of the screens as I do within ScreenFlow, but it's all being captured in ScreenFlow. Now I should warn you, if you're gonna try and use this for presentations, you're in the field and you're doing a presentation and you say have a MacBook or a notebook computer and you want to display your computer screen, you both have to be on the same Wi-Fi network, and it has to be a fairly open network. I think if in some like conference centers and stuff, I've run into issues where I'm on the same network, but AirPlay won't work. It won't allow streaming through, so there's something shut down in the network that stops that from happening. The workaround is to turn your phone into a hotspot and then connect your computer to your phone and use that as your network in order to display the screen if that is important to you in the presentation world. So a pretty simple little tutorial today, how I get my screens how I record my screens. Now I did say that it's a bit of a challenge in the Windows or Android world, and I haven't found an elegant solution for getting Android screens and recording them here onto my Mac. I just haven't figured that out. If you can figure it out, please go into the comments below and tell me how it's done, because for me, it's been an exercise in frustration getting there. I just haven't been able to crack that code. There are some ways to record, for instance, in the Samsung world, to record the Galaxy screen onto Samsung notebooks, because there's some firmware and stuff that Samsung builds into their products. But generally speaking, getting an Android. So that's why I do so many demos in the Mac, in iOS, because it's easy for me to show. Far more difficult for me to get the Android screen to display. If I can figure it out, I'll be doing lots more Android demos. I can promise you that. Well, I hope you found this little video today to be useful. If you have, of course, there's three ways that you can be a part of our community here at Dotto Tech. You can subscribe to this channel, which I encourage you to do. You can subscribe to our newsletter, which I also encourage you to do. In subscribing to our newsletter, you will get a weekly newsletter from us, which includes all of our videos, as well as any upcoming special events or webinars that we might be hosting. And finally, this channel is brought to you by you through your generous support in Patreon. Dotto Tech is a crowd-funded channel. In other words, our audience are the ones who pay instead of having corporate sponsors. And for as little as $1 a month, which works out to something around 5 cents a video that I produce, you too can become a Patreon sponsor. I encourage you to take a look at our Patreon page, see if it's something that you might be willing to engage in. And then if you do, great. And if you don't, at least you had a look, and I appreciate that as well. And I mostly appreciate you just spending your time with me today. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle!